إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، اعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الإخوة والأخوات، here we are after the end of the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has truly blessed us with the ni'mah of being alive to benefit and take the advantage of the month of Ramadan. And here we are now that the month is over. We need to ponder and reflect and take lessons from that month of Ramadan in which we were engaged in ibadah, and we were engaged in acts of worship, and we were effortless, we were putting our effort in every single day, trying our very best to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to have our sins pardoned and forgiven, engaging in fasting, engaging in prayer at night, engaging in the recitation of the Quran, in the remembrance of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, in doing all of those things that we have been commanded to do, staying away from all those things we have been commanded to stay away from, and put into practice and into action the real purpose and objective of that month, which is to attain taqwa, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned with regards to fasting, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you may attain taqwa. That's why we have been commanded to fast. And taqwa, in short, is doing those things that we have been commanded to do and staying away from that which we have been told to stay away from. So now that we reflect and we think back, lesson number one we take away from the month of Ramadan is just the way that month came and went by so quick, our lives will also end very quickly, and time will go by really fast. But we have to ask ourselves, what have we brought forth in terms of our responsibility towards Allah, which is submitting to Him tabaraka wa ta'ala and worshipping Him alone and following the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Secondly, as the pious predecessors did after Ramadan came to an end, we plead and we beg and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our ibadat and our acts of worship in the month of Ramadan. And we have hope, even though we have some type of fear that maybe we didn't do our best, we didn't come forth with the best possible actions, but we make dua and we ask Allah and we hope that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will accept our ibadat. And remember, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, Allah will accept the ibadah from those people who have taqwa. إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. So we hope and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it from the people of taqwa and to accept our ibadat. And we shouldn't be complacent, and we shouldn't be, you know, at ease with simply what we have done alone. But we should continue in trying to do more after the month of Ramadan. And with regards to what we have done before, we hope and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it. But the danger is when we have done actions and we think everything is okay. And we think everything is perfect. But rather we should be those who work very hard and try their very best and have a little bit of concern that maybe, just maybe, Allah didn't accept it. But you keep on trying and you don't lose hope. And that's the reality of the mu'min. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says about the believers, they are the ones who bring forth their a'mal and they do their actions. وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. But their hearts have some type of fear. They're going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're going to be held accountable for what they have done. Aisha radiallahu anha, she asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, is this referring to the people who committed sins? Who stole or drank alcohol or committed things that are haram? Are they the ones that are going to be in this state? And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, rather it is the one who prays and fasts. He does his actions to the best of his abilities, but there's a type of, there's a little bit of fear. And that's what keeps the mu'min in check. And that is the difference between the mu'min and the munafiq. لذلك الحسن البصري رحمه الله تعالى, he said that the difference between the mu'min and the munafiq, إن المؤمن جمع إحسانا وشفقة. The mu'min, he does his a'mal and his actions with ihsan, but there's a little bit of fear. But the munafiq is the one who جمع بين إساءة وأمنا. He is the one who, he does his actions with, he does not do it with perfection. He does not try. He's lazy. He puts no emphasis and no inayah in his ibadah, but he's convinced that he's okay. So we hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our actions. And from the signs that our actions will be accepted is that we continue after the month of Ramadan in doing those ibadat and those acts of khair. So we were fasting in the month of Ramadan. Try to continue fasting after the month of Ramadan. Fast every Monday and every Thursday. Try our best to fast on the 3 days of every month, the 14th and the 13th and the 14th and the 15th of every Islamic month. Try your best to pray a portion of the night. And ala al-aqal, do not leave the witr. We were engaged in the recitation and the reading of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's not stop that because Ramadan is over. Let us continue in reading the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And more importantly, let's take it further and make it a point to try to learn and understand the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the purpose and the objective of the Quran being revealed upon us is for us to understand and to ponder and to reflect and to put it to action. لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ أَوَلَمْ يَدَّبَّرُوا الْقَوْلِ أَفَلَا يَتَدَّبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Over and over again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it clear for us that the purpose and the objective of the book of Allah being revealed is for us to learn it and understand it and ponder upon it and reflect and put it to action in our lives. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to continue in the a'mal dar of khair that we have been doing in Ramadan and continue it in the months afterwards in Shawwal and Dhul-Qa'da and Dhul-Hijjah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our good deeds, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who listen and benefit from what we hear. نسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن يجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, from the act of worship that we're encouraged to do after the month of Ramadan is fasting 6 days in the month of Shawwal. The Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام, he told us that a person who fasts in the month of Ramadan and then follows up the fasting in Ramadan by fasting 6 days in Shawwal, then it is as if they have fasted for the entire year. And this is from the opportunities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us to engage in acts of worship and increase in reward and remove and wipe away sins. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gives us opportunity and chance after chance. But it is upon us to utilize and take advantage of it. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to continue in fasting as we've done in the month of Ramadan and the other months afterwards, and making it a means for us to get closer to Him, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Lastly, it's important that we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq and success in continuing in doing the acts that are righteous. Because if it's not for the help of Allah, and if it's not for the aid of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, we will not be able to engage in this ibadah. And that's why we have to understand this very important concept, that we rely fully on Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and we depend on Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to that which is khair, to guide us to the right path, to keep us firm on the correct path, to keep us firm in doing the acts of worship correctly, to grant us understanding of this deen so that we can worship Him properly and stay firm upon that. Especially in the times that we're living in now, where we are surrounded with fitan, whether those fitan are doubts and desires or desires, we are surrounded by it. And we are constantly under this barrage and attack of shubuhat and shahawat. So we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to keep us firm and to protect us and to protect our children from all of the different trials and tribulations. And we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to keep us firm on this haqq, hatta ya'tiyana al-yaqeen, until that which is certain comes to us, which is al-maut. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us firm until the end. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for our shortcomings and our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on all of those Muslims who have passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, protect our children, keep us firm on Sirat al-Mustaqim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our ibadat and all of our good deeds that we have been engaged in, and keep us firm in continuing in doing that which is khair until the time comes where we meet Him tabaraka wa ta'ala. Sallu wa sallim ala khatim al-anbiya wal-mursaleen. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala abdika wa rasulika Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Warda Allahumma ani sahabati wa tabi'in wa tabi'ihim wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin. Allahumma a'izzal islam wal muslimin, وأذل الشرك والمشركين، وانصر عبادك الموحدين، وجعلنا من أنصار الدين. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، تب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استووا أقيموا صفوفكم واعتدلوا. Make sure all of the lines are straight, leave no gaps. Make sure there are no gaps. استووا واعتدلوا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. يسبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض الملك القدوس العزيز الحكيم. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين.
وآخرين منهم لما يلحقوا بهم وهو العزيز الحكيم ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا بئس مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآيات الله والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين قل يا أيها الذين هادوا إن زعمتم أنكم أولياء لله من دون الناس إن زعمتم أنكم أولياء لله من دون الناس فتمنوا الموت إن كنتم صادقين ولا يتمنونه أبدا بما قدمت أيديهم والله عليم بالظالمين قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إذا جاءك المنافقون قالوا نشهد إنك لرسول الله والله يعلم إنك لرسوله والله يشهد إن المنافقين لكاذبون اتخذوا أيمانهم جنة فصدوا عن سبيل الله إنهم ساء ما كانوا يعملون ذلك بأنهم آمنوا ثم كفروا فطبع على قلوبهم فهم لا يفقهون وإذا رأيتهم تعجبك أجسامهم وإن يقولوا تسمع لقولهم كأنهم خشب مسندة يحسبون كل صيحة عليهم هم العدو فاحذرهم قاتلهم الله أنى يؤفكون
وإذا قيل لهم تعالوا يستغفر لكم رسول الله لووا رؤوسهم ورأيتهم يصدون وهم مستكبرون سواء عليهم أستغفرت لهم أم لم تستغفر لهم لن يغفر الله لهم إن الله لا يهدي القوم الفاسقين هم الذين يقولون لا تنفقوا على من عند رسول الله حتى ينفضوا ولله خزائن السماوات والأرض ولكن المنافقين لا يفقهون يقولون لئن رجعنا إلى المدينة ليخرجن الأعز منها الأذل ولله العزة ولرسوله وللمؤمنين ولكن المنافقين لا يعلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون الله سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
الحمد لله.